Okay, let us now continue with the Debye-Kerckel limiting law. What is Debye-Kerckel limiting law? It gives the relation between the mean activity coefficient. This is mean activity coefficient, gamma plus or log gamma plus or minus equal to minus a. A is a constant. Modulus of z plus z minus modulus I to the power 1 by 2. Okay. Now, this gives the relation between the log of mean activity coefficient and the ionic strength. Ionic strength we have seen in the last video. Ionic strength is can be calculated for a given electrolytic solution. So if we know the ionic strength, we can calculate the ionic strength. We know the formula and charge on the cation, charge on the anion. This also we know. This also we know. A is a constant. We know. Therefore, we can calculate the mean activity coefficient. Mean activity, gamma plus or minus is mean molar activity coefficient can be calculated. What is A? A equal to 1.82 into 10 power 6 divided by epsilon into T to the power 3 by 2, where epsilon is the dielectric constant of the medium. For example, for water, the dielectric constant of water is 80. Dielectric constant is equal to permittivity of the substance water divided by permittivity of the free space. Therefore, the dielectric constant of water has no unit. And temperature, for example, 25 degrees Celsius, 298. If you substitute in this expression, you will get the A value as this. Okay, this is the A value for water. This is for water. And okay, now it can be plotted. This is a straight line equation. For example, if you take this as y, and this will be x, that is to the power square root of x. If you take I, x equal to I to the power 1 by 2, you can plot. Therefore, as you see, minus is there, therefore negative slope. If it is positive slope, it will be like this. This is negative slope because the slope is negative minus. For example, if you plot mean activity coefficient versus square root of ionic strength, the curve obtained is like this. A straight line is obtained with a slight deviation. Will be a curve, slight curve, and for calcium chloride the slope is large, and the zinc sulfate it is the largest. Why? So just look at that. What is the slope here? The slope is nothing but m equal to minus 0.59 into z plus z minus. Okay, z minus. Therefore, the slope. For example, case for sodium chloride, Z plus is 1 and Z minus is 1, minus 1. Therefore, what you will get is the slope is 0.509. Okay? Therefore, 1 into 1. Similarly, if you take for calcium chloride, okay, calcium chloride Z equal to plus 2. The charge on the cation is plus 2 and the charge on the chloride ion minus is minus 1. Therefore, you will get 2 times. The slope for calcium chloride is 0.509 into 2 times. Therefore, the slope is steeper. For example, if you take zinc sulfate, okay, you can calculate the slope. Your problem will be asked based on this. So, for calcium chloride, for zinc sulfate, Z equal to plus 2 and Z equal to anion equal to minus 2. Therefore, you will get 2 into 2 modulus. Therefore, what you will get is 2 into 2, 4. 4 times. So, the slope is greater. The slope is, it is much steeper because of this. We can calculate it. So, if you know that, for example, we know the ionic strength of the electrolytic solution can be calculated. A is known for example, for electrolyte Z plus, Z minus known. Therefore, we can calculate the mean activity coefficient by using Debye-Kerckel limiting law. Okay, there were several problems as in CSIR as well as GATE and also in SET. Mean activity coefficient. What is mean activity coefficient? So, we have seen here, we have not defined. So, what is the importance? activity coefficient. Activity is directly proportional to, for example, even in plus 2, you are studying activity. It is not the concentration, the activity is very important. See, for example, you are in the classroom, but your activity is zero. You are not listening to the teacher. When you don't listen to that, the activity is zero. Although you are here, similarly, the concentration may be unity, but the activity is less. Activity is always less. Therefore, because of the activity is directly proportional to molarity. Molarity is nothing but the concentration of the electrolyte. Molarity, why do we take molarity? Molarity does not depend on temperature, whereas concentration, normality depends on temperature, because molarity does not depend on temperature, because number of moles does not depend on temperature. Weight of the solvent, it is number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 kg of the solvent. Weight of the solvent does not depend on temperature, whereas volume of the solution depends on the temperature. Normality, molarity depends on temperature. It is A proportional to molarity. Activity is directly proportional to its concentration or molarity. Therefore, gamma is the activity coefficient. For example, if you take Mx, it will dissociate to give M plus and H minus. Therefore, the activity A plus A minus. Okay. So the mean activity is the product of activity of the cation and product of the activity of the anion. Therefore, it will be A plus or minus 2. Okay, this is the mean activity. We are not interested in the individual activity of the cation and anion, because in the electrolytic solution, if you consider an electrolytic solution, the total number of positive charge is equal to total number of negative charge. Therefore, there is no need to calculate the A plus A minus. We need to know only the mean activity coefficient of the electrolyte. So this is the mean activity coefficient of the electrolyte. Okay, this is a simple case. Let us consider a general case, Mx, Ay, X into Xm, Y plus. Therefore, Y is there. Therefore, Y, Ax minus. For example, we have discussed aluminium trihydroxide, Al3 plus 3OH minus. Therefore, solubility is S and 3S. See, for example, 3. This will come here, 3S, Ya minus. Okay, now the activity coefficient, mean activity coefficient gamma plus or minus M, or activity, this is activity equal to, what you will get is X A plus whole power X, for example here. Okay, 1, whole power 1. Therefore, X, similarly Y, activity of A minus power Y. Therefore, activity of this one, activity of A plus, for example, equal to gamma plus M. Molarity is the same. One mole here also. One mole means this will be mole. Okay, therefore, mole into power X. Similarly, Y, A minus gamma minus M to the power Y. Therefore, X power X, Y power Y, and M power X plus M is same here. Therefore, X plus Y, gamma plus X, gamma Y minus. Therefore, activity of the electrolyte, activity of the mean activity of the electrolyte is equal to this. This will be the gamma plus or minus based on that. M plus M minus. Therefore, gamma plus or minus X plus X, 1 plus 1 here, X plus Y. For example, here you can calculate the activity of the activity can be determined from the various experiments. Activity can be determined from depression of freezing point and elevation of boiling point. Activity can be determined. If we know the activity, we can calculate the gamma and the mean activity coefficient also. For example, how it is calculated here, for example, KCl, X equal to 1. Here X becomes 1. This is 1, 1, 1. KCl 1, 1. Therefore, 1, 1, that is equal to A equal to, in this formula you substitute 1 power 1. Therefore, M 1 plus 1, 2, gamma plus 1, 1. Therefore, gamma plus or minus 2. So this is the activity and relation between the mean activity coefficient. Similarly, you can calculate for activity of K2SO4. Okay, so for x equal to here, x equal to 2, because 2k plus will be obtained, 2k plus, therefore you will get 2 power 2, okay, 2 power 2, x power, and y power 1, 1 power 1, right, okay, m x plus y, 3, and gamma plus or minus x plus y, again this is 3, therefore it is equal to 4 m cube gamma plus or minus. Okay, so how the activity can be calculated, from the mean? So gamma plus or minus can be obtained from this graph. Okay, the activity coefficient is always less than 1. For example, at infinite dilution, at very very low concentration, A equal to gamma equal to 1. Okay, so here gamma equal to 1 for very very dilute solution, very very dilute solution. Therefore, activity of the electrolyte is equal to molality or concentration. Activity is equal to at infinite dilution or at very low concentration. If you plot molality versus concentration. If you plot molality versus concentration, molality versus square root of molality, you will get like this. And actually, it will be at infinite, that is concentration molality, at zero molality, at infinite dilution, it will be 1. This value is 1. So it will be 0.4 something, 4 or 0.3. So for calcium chloride, if you look at calcium chloride, it is slightly peculiar. It will be greater. See, as concentration increases, greater than, we don't know the reason yet. But at infinite dilution, at very low dilution, activity is equal to its concentration. In general, in plus 2 and all, the activity is assumed to be its concentration, because we take the mean activity coefficient equal to 1. It is based on this. Okay. Thank you very much.